Welcome to the short episode, dueling box breaks or dueling box reviews. I've got a couple boxes here for Panini that are football. So one is Luminance and the other is Chronicles. And again, very different products in their configuration, but not surprisingly, they're almost exactly the same price in the marketplace. And one of the main drivers, as many of you know, of the box price is how many autographs and memorabilia cards. Those are kind of the assets that are scarce that Panini has to go out and get and put into the cards, into the packs. So even though there's a different number of cards, the determination of the value in the box is usually heavily, or at least a very somewhat proportional to the number of autographs and memorabilia cards. So there's the jerseys and the player actually physically signing the card. So in both of these that are $225 or so for the box, three autographs per box, one memorabilia card. And then the rest are inserts and parallels and rookies. And depending on how you like this, well, let's just start out. Well, first of all, thanks sponsors. Thanks Panini for setting these couple of boxes to look at and for me to share my experience. Thanks Tops, thanks Upper Deck, thanks Burbank Sports Cards, Mike Stadium Sports Cards, Heritage Auctions, Huggins Scott Auctions, CompC.com, and Beckett Media, Beckett Grading, Beckett Authentication. So started with Luminance, and I had some Luminance last year. I think I don't like the finish of the card as much as I do the more standard. It's a little flat, it's a little muted. The backgrounds, the action photos, I think some people really like those. I'm not a huge fan of that. I do think it's good to see things that aren't just staged to make it look artificial, but probably not my favorite design. The not facsimile autographs, but the names in kind of a script at the bottom and different foil treatments depending on parallels. That's interesting. When you look at this, there's only 40 cards in the box. So four packs, 10 cards in a pack. And so the whole box for $225 is going to give you 40 cards. So are they going to be $5 each? Of course not. Some are going to be a lot less, and some hopefully are going to be a lot more, but certainly many of them will be more. But if you look at it the way it's presented, it looks like there's only going to be 15 base cards out of the 40. So that sounds good that you've got more than half the cards have some distinction, that less than half are base cards. In this case, though, the base cards are some of the veterans and a nice configuration of veterans. And many of these other special cards are really just rookie cards in the base set. So I think they're a little bit tougher, but not so much tougher that, well, again, one of the encouraging things in the industry is that base cards of rookies and even base cards of veteran players in certain brands now is bringing a surprising value. So the base cards are not to be left behind in many of these brands, including Luminous and Chronicles that'll be next. So I enjoyed it. My best card, which may or may not make my wall. Actually, I'm going to set it aside in case he does have a strong start. It's Gardner Minshew. It's an autograph. Actually, Gardner Minshew the second, but there's a numbered autograph card of Gardner, and he's quirky, and that's okay, but he needs to be good as well. And if he's good, then he will make my wall. So I'm going to set that aside. Future choice. So Luminance, early lead. Got reasonable value in the box. But now on to Chronicles. Very different product. I've gotten Chronicles before. I think I got Chronicles baseball, maybe not Chronicles football, but I love the Chronicles concept. I think if you're a complete set collector, then you can put together a Luminance set and work on that. But if you're a player collector or a team collector or a college collector, I think that Chronicles has a lot going for it. It's almost all rookies. I think when you add it all up, it's probably almost all the cards are, well, the base is a rookie. And when these smaller condensed and distilled versions or brands that Panini has manufactured have shorter lists. And so they're really heavy on quarterbacks. So I got several Tuas, several Joe Burrows, a couple of Jordan Loves, Justin Herbert, Jerry Jeudy. I got some of the non-quarterback. I got a CeeDee Lamb. That actually may go on my wall, although it's an optic rated rookie. So I thought that was cool. So it's not signed or numbered, but it's still a very attractive card. And I may have that as a placeholder since he is touted to be the next great Cowboys wide receiver. I did get Justin Jefferson in a memorabilia card, and I think he's the real deal. So on balance, I've got, oh, the other thing that I just wanted to point out, and this may also be true of some people, I don't know that I'm the only one, but the other thing that tips the scales toward Chronicles is that I'm now, you know, with the local colleges here and a lot of my friends being Baylor, A&M, I went to SMU, University of Texas, all those, it's really cool. In the Chronicles set, I picked up several more cards of players that go to those, to my friends' alma maters. So those will go into the, well, I don't do plastic sheets, but I have a system for that. So if you're over, I'll show you what my system is, but it's nice to pick up cards that I have a use for. And those that I don't, if they're common cards, I generally give them to Rich Klein. So everything in the hobby has a home. I really enjoyed opening the Chronicles box. So it takes first place of these two football boxes, given the same amount of price. I think I would, being a player collector, and the value of kind of base commons or base rookie cards, it tips the scales toward Chronicles for me. But well done, Panini, on both. Thank you again for the boxes. Thanks, sponsors. Enjoy this little dueling boxes. I declare Chronicles to be the winner.